So, how is your summer, Arjun? I mean, there's an election coming up and it's been really intense.
I mean, there's so many issues that are at the forefront right now that candidates are talking about, but I think climate change, it really stands out. When I go on my Instagram, all I'm seeing my friends and my family members posting and advocating for people to take this issue more serious. And I know, Alexia, you went out to the West Coast and you saw a bunch of fires in BC. That's crazy.
Yeah, I was in BC during the really intense heat wave and it was very hot. And I also drove through the highway after it was reopened and it was so smoky. It felt like I was outside when I was in my car. I don't even want to know what it was like outside. But yeah, it's crazy. This is such an important issue. Okay, so before we jump in, here are a few quick facts on where greenhouse gas emissions come from in Canada. About 50% comes from big industries, including oil and gas production, other manufacturing and electricity generation, such as coal and gas plants, and the other 50% come from small sources like households, farms, small businesses, personal vehicles, and landfills.
And Canada is one of the top 10 biggest polluting countries in the world. We've missed every emissions target we've ever set, no matter which party was in power, and emissions have only increased since 1992.
Well, good news. There's an election coming up, like I said, and so I think we should check out what the candidates are bringing to the table.
We knew when Canadians elected us in 2015 that we had to go bigger and stronger and more concretely on fighting climate change. And that's exactly what we did over these past 6 years.
I've been crystal clear why climate change is important to me, not just as a politician. I talk about climate change with my daughter, Molly, who's 15, and we need to make our emission targets as a country.
Because the whole planet would tell the conservatives and the liberals who have given even more money to oil and gas than the conservatives of Stephen Harper before them. It should appeal to this fight that we have to fight against climate change.
And we can tackle this if we make this a priority. And the other thing we want to do is create good jobs that help us fight the climate crisis. We know there's an opportunity here to create thousands and thousands of jobs that help us reduce emissions. That's our approach. Take on the big polluters and create good jobs that reduce our emissions.
We are not going to forget that the world is counting on Canada as a wealthy nation, as an abundant nation, to do its part to tackle the climate emergency.
There is a lot to unpack here, and it's complicated. Make sure to keep watching because later on we'll evaluate how effective each party's platform is at fighting climate change. But first, let's bring in our expert. It's very nice to meet you.
Yeah. It's great to meet both of you. This is like my favorite interview of the week, I've got to say.
Oh, that's great to hear. We keep hearing about targets, right? All of the parties have different ones. They keep talking about reducing greenhouse gas emissions by a certain percentage below 2005 levels by 2030. Can you explain what all of this means?
So, under the Paris Agreement, which was negotiated in 2015, all countries come to the table with a target to reduce their emissions. Now, they have different base years. The most ambitious countries, like in Europe, use 1990 as their base year. Canada uses 2005 because we messed up from 1990 to 2005, and so we just don't want to talk about that. So in Paris, we committed to reduce our emissions by 30% below that 2005 base year by 2030. And Canada has announced a new target, which is to reduce emissions to 40 to 45% below 2005 levels by that same 2030 target year.
Okay, now let's look at all the different parties. They all use the same time frame of 2005 levels by 2030.
The conservative target is 30% reduction, while the liberals' target is 40 to 45%. The NDP say 50% and the Greens say 60%. Let's move on to how they will achieve these goals. The Liberals introduced a carbon tax a few years ago. A tax means that the government takes a percentage of what we spend on things we buy, like electronics and clothes, and puts it towards things that we all need, like military and healthcare. Now, can you explain what the carbon tax is and how it works?
Carbon taxes work by making more polluting activities more expensive. So they apply an extra cost to fossil fuels, coal, natural gas. People do respond to prices. When you increase the price of gasoline with a carbon tax, people buy more fuel efficient vehicles. So we know that it works, but we also know that we need to have higher prices than we've had previously. Now, one of the things the Trudeau government did is they established a consistent national carbon price across Canada in every province for both households and industry. And they established a schedule to gradually increase that carbon price over time.
And the NDPs and the Greens, they support this idea of a carbon tax. But the Conservatives, if they kind of want to switch it up if they were to be elected. Can you explain this Conservative plan to me? Because when I first read about it, it was unique compared to the other plans that I've read about, like the Liberals, Greens, and NDP. It has to do with the personal savings account.
They've got two parts. They've got carbon pricing for industrial polluters, and they say that they might match the Liberals' carbon schedule, carbon price schedule, but they might not. So that's an important area of uncertainty for industry. But for households, what the Conservatives have said is that instead of the Liberals' carbon tax at the pump, they will establish carbon savings accounts. So every time your parents put money in the family car, the amount of money that is collected will be put into a savings account and can only be spent on certain green activities. They haven't said what those
Well, they said a transit pass, bicycles, efficient furnaces, windows, or even electric vehicles, where that money could go.
There's two problems with that. The first is that often programs like that people end up buying exactly what they were going to buy anyway. Kids grow out of their bicycles and their families buy them new bicycles. And so this carbon savings plan isn't causing people to do anything differently than they would have otherwise. And if that's the case, it's not encouraging them to reduce their gasoline use. The other thing is that the Conservatives would lower the price. So the current carbon tax is $40 per ton. That's about 4.5 cents per liter. It's not that much. They would reduce it to $20 per ton, and they would only increase it to $50 per ton, whereas the Liberals would increase it to $170 per ton. So they just wouldn't use that price incentive to the same degree the Liberals will.
So a carbon tax that the other parties have promoted as a part of their own party is a better way, you think, of reducing greenhouse gas emissions, a more efficient way?
Yes, it's a more efficient way. It tends to cost less. There's that opportunity to give money back, and that can be very progressive. It can help lower income families. It takes money from wealthy people and transfers it to lower income families.
Okay, we need to mention the Bloc Québécois. So the Bloc has a platform that is pretty different from any other party's platform. They don't make the same types of promises. Can you explain why that is?
The Bloc Québécois will never form government because they don't even run candidates outside Quebec. So they're never going to get more seats than any other party. But they also, the issues on which they pressure the federal government tend to be quite specific. So they look for more money for Quebec, and they look for compensation to Quebec if they think other provinces have been given too much money. So they tend to focus on the money, and they avoid calling for Canada-wide regulatory mandates.
All right, now it's time to look at which party is offering the most effective plan to help Canada reduce its carbon emissions.
We spoke to three experts for this. None of them support a particular party, and that's really important because we want their input based on their expertise, not their biases.
So let's start with the Liberals. They have ambitious targets to reduce greenhouse gases. They have a carbon tax, regulations, and lots of details. but they don't say how they plan to achieve these targets by 2030. And they are building the Trans Mountain Pipeline, which allows for the expansion of oil and gas production.
All right, turning to the conservatives. So their plan is better than previous conservative plans to tackle climate change. But their targets to reduce emissions are only going backwards. Their carbon tax on industry is not a sure thing. And they want to protect oil and gas jobs rather than find ways to transform that sector to make it greener.
Okay, looking at the NDP, they have an ambitious plan, which includes a carbon tax, a transition away from fossil fuels, and they plan to stop subsidizing that sector. But it's not clear where all the money will come from.
And finally, the Green Party. They want to ban all fossil fuel subsidies, put a high price on carbon, and phase out oil and gas production. But there is no cost to their plan and it involves a sudden, dramatic shift in the oil and gas industry.
Wow, that conversation was so interesting and I learned so much.
Yeah, Alexia, it was great to speak with Kathryn Harrison. She's obviously so educated about the subject and I definitely learned a lot, much like you. But if you have a lot more questions about climate change and where each party stands on the topic, be sure to look at their platform for a lot more information.
Yeah, for sure. Make sure to talk to your parents or any adults in your life about this because they're going to go out and vote. And it's really good to educate ourselves on these topics because one day we're going to go and vote and it's always good to be prepared.
All right. Be sure to check out our website, cbckidsnews.ca, for more coverage on the election.
For CBC Kids News, I'm Alexia Sabau.
And I'm Arjun Ram.